Hello class 5, welcome to history lecture. We are continuing with our chapter Age of Revolution, and there we are doing the French Revolution. We have already seen the social causes, so today we will see the political causes which were responsible for the outbreak of the French Revolution. So we do the political causes. Political causes means the matters which are related to the state. Now here, before we start the political causes, we have to remember that the French Revolution broke out in 1789, the landmark event. 1789 date is very important, you have to remember this. The French Revolution broke out from this year, and we see that this revolution, the French Revolution, affected not only the history of France but the history of the entire world. This demand for liberty, equality and fraternity was first started in France. In America also the demand for liberty was there, but we see it did not affected the whole world in such a manner that it affected after the French Revolution. So these messages of French Revolution was spread all over the world, and other countries which were also struggling to gain their independence or freedom, they also followed the French Revolution to gain their freedom, to gain their equalities, and to gain the freedom from the clutches of their atrocious ruler. So here we'll see that the French ruler, the King Louis XVI, was the king under whom the French Revolution broke out. So the king during the French Revolution was Louis XVI. Now what we see is that there were several factors for which the French Revolution broke out, and we will see the political factor. In the political factor we will see that the king Louis XVI was not liked by the people much. So in France there was the theory of divine origin theory, divine right of kingship. In this theory, this was followed in France, divine right of kingship. Now listen carefully and try to understand what is divine right of kingship. In this divine right of kingship, it is believed that king is the representative of God. King is representing God. Whatever God wants to say, God says through the king. This was believed in France, this theory, divine right of kingship. But when Louis XVI became the king, he did not have such personality, or he was not so popular among the people that people will believe in him. So people did not believe him as a representative of God, and they did not wanted to obey to their King Louis XVI. So this theory of divine right of kingship was gradually declining. This was one of the main reasons that the people gathered strength and they wanted to stand against the king. Previously the people believed that king is sent by God, so they never protested against the king. Now the people started believing that the king is not sent by God, so they started protesting against the king. So this was a divine right of kingship. So this theory of kingship which people used to believe in France, now they are not believing. That for that Louis XVI was very much responsible. Louis XVI personality was not such that people will believe him as a representative of God. Next we see that the Queen Marie Antoinette also lived a very extravagant life. Extravagant life means she spent, she was a queen and she spent so much money for her own personal need. This money they are taking from the state exchequer. So the king and the queen was using the money of the country for their own personal need. This was also not liked by the people when they came to know about this. So this was another political reason for the people to go against the king. Also we see that the king had passed a law, anarchical laws were passed, that is arrest without any warrant, without any papers. So we see that Louis XVI wanted to arrest anyone who is saying anything against him. That is why he started a new law that anyone can be arrested if he or she is suspected. So this was known as arrest without any warrant. Even if there is no paper, no proof that why he is being arrested, then also that person can be arrested. So he started the new law, that is arrest without any warrant. Apart from these factors, that is divine right of kingship failed, Marie Antoinette was spending so much money from the state, then new law was passed, that is anybody can be arrested if they say anything against the king. This was also not liked by the people. The people were already so much disappointed and angry with the king. They were planning for a revolt also. And in this situation, we see that the France was involved in so many war. And all the war, they were losing. France was losing all the war. So international prestige of France was also suffering. Internationally, France was involved in so many war. And see that France was losing all the war. So they are spending so much money for warfare, but they are losing the war. These all factors made the people to stand against the king and to protest against the activity of the king. So these are basically the political factor, the factor regarding the state for which the common people went against the king. So we see that these political causes are another important cause of the French Revolution, for which the people came into front to protest against the king. In next class, we will do about other causes, the economic causes and the causes for the, that is the writing of the philosophers. How these two factors also played important role in the French Revolution, that we will see. Thank you.